الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكملان على خير خلق الله أجمعين، نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، we praise Allah سبحانه وتعالى abundantly and we ask Him to exalt and mention and grant His peace and salutations upon the Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام. As to what follows, we heard tonight Surah Fussilat, please, in the second part of the Taraweeh. And of course, again, Surah Fussilat has some narrations related to it. And it was one of the surah which the Prophet ﷺ recited upon one of the kuffar of Quraysh until when he made it to the statement of Allah Azza wa Jal that I warn you of a disaster like that one which afflicted Ad and Thamud. He put his hand on his mouth not to continue. The disbeliever did not want the Prophet ﷺ to continue reciting because he knew deep within that it was a haqq. But that's not the thing we wanted to highlight. What we wanted to highlight is the ayat which says, after Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned that the disbelievers, that this of course applies to the believers, that on Yawm al-Qiyamah, حَتَّى إِذَا مَا جَاءُوهَا شَهِدَ عَلَيْهِمْ سَمْعُهُمْ وَأَبْصَارُهُمْ وَجُلُودُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Until when they come to it, then their hearing and their sight and their skin, they will bear witness against them of that which they used to do. And they will say to them, why did you testify against us? So you're talking to yourself. Your own limbs will testify against you. So they will say to them, لِمَ شَهِدْتُمْ عَلَيْنَا? Why are you testifying against us? They will say, قَالُوا أَنْتَقَمَ اللَّهُ الَّذِي أَنْتَقَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. Allah made us speak, the one who made everything speak. Then the ayat got interesting. And then Allah Azza wa Jal says in the next ayah, you have the son of Adam is in such a heedless state that he forgets that our limbs will bear witness against us. And so Allah Azza wa Jal said, you almost forgot that your hearing and your sight and your skin will bear witness against you. This thought of yours is what caused destruction. So this is what we want to pause right now. The reminder which we have to extract from these ayat is, what are we using our ears and sight and limbs in general for? What I'm saying is, we can get away with a lot of stuff now. Meaning we can disobey Allah Azza wa Jal and no one knows about it. Because in general, Allah Azza wa Jal hides the sins of people, right? Allah Azza wa Jal is sittir, by the way, not sittar, as commonly spread among the Muslims. Abdus Sattar is not, Sattar is not a valid name of the names of Allah. The actual name as for the Quran and Sunnah is Sittir. And the one Sittir is the one who covers up. So Allah Azza wa Jal is merciful to us that whatever we do is often not known to the people. The problem is that the things which we do publicly, that's a whole other discussion. But for the things which we do behind closed doors in secret, we may get away with it now. But then on Yawm al-Qiyamah, there will be a serious issue that our own limbs will testify against us. Now the eye will say what we used to see with it, and the ear will say what we used to hear with it, and the skin, what we used to do with our bodies. And then we will start having a debate with our own selves. Why are you doing this? You're supposed to help me out. And then they will say, Allah Azza wa Jal made us speak. So this is an invitation to repent to Allah. In the month of Ramadan now is an opportunity, because we have the ability, we have the strength, we assume the iman to overcome a lot of our shortcomings. Ramadan, specifically in these virtuous nights, is the time to make that resolve now. Meaning each one on his own, we know what we were doing and what we have done that only Allah knows about. If we repent from these sins completely and we don't go back to them, we have the niyyah at least not to go back to them, then as per the promise of Allah, they will be erased from the book of deeds. Erased. Yani on Yawm al-Qiyamah you will come, no one knows. As it comes in some of the narrations, Allah will draw his slave near to him. And Allah will cover him away from the people. Then he will tell him, you did such and such, and you did such and such, and you did such and such. The things which we did in secret that no one knows. And the slave will say, I admit, O Allah, I confess. Allah will say, I hid them from the people in the dunya, I covered them in the dunya, and today I will forgive you. Now, and then that person will be admitted to Jannah, alhamdulillah. No one will know. There will be no fadiha, no public disgrace. This is if we do what though? Tawbah. That's why it is important to repent from these sins. If we, however, continue, then we are exposing ourselves to what comes after. We are exposing ourselves that these ayat will become applicable to us. And we are endangering our life and the life to come. So now that we're in Ramadan, and the shayateen or the evil among them or the powerful among them are chained, you find that you have high resistance against sin. When sin approaches you, you have the ability and the strength to stay away from it. Outside of Ramadan, it's not that easy. It's much easier to fall into the sin. So this is the training period. Training period to learn how to control ourselves. Furthermore, this is the time to repent from these sins. Because after Ramadan, we do not want to go back to them. Now, most likely no one will fall into these sins in Ramadan, most likely. But after Ramadan, from the first minute, the Maghrib and the night of Eid, we're back at risk. You'll feel it. You will feel it. It's the Ramadan flavor will be gone. And the shayateen will be back out. That's why from the very day of Eid, half of the people miss Fajr, and the other half miss Salatul Eid, and the other half don't come for Dhuhr, and the rest of them are out, and I don't know what, listening to music, and partying already. As if we didn't go through Ramadan and Taraweeh and Ibadah, nothing, it was just a ritual. It must have an impact. So music, put a big X on music for the teenagers. Whether it is Western music or Eastern music or any type of music, there's no music, there's no room for music in Islam. If you want evidences for that, go on YouTube and watch the lecture, The Classical Hit, It's Bad. Remember the title, The Classical Hit, It's Bad. All of the ayat of the Quran, because we have it in the Quran, Surah Luqman, and seven ahadith from the Prophet ﷺ, proving the fact that music and singing are prohibited in Islam. Music and singing. If someone will say that I will just sing without the music, or music, without, it doesn't matter, instrumental as they call it. No room for that in Islam. Now for many of us, this is, wow, really? But, I mean, music, man. You know, everybody listens to music. It's part of our life, my culture, my family, my batiq. This is meaningless. If it's haram, it's haram. And the hadith mentions that Allah will destroy the people who will be listening and engaged in this, and some of them will be transformed into pigs and monkeys until Yawm al-Qiyamah. And the hadith is in Bukhari. Bukhari, Sahih Bukhari, about the prohibition of music and musical instruments and singing. So the ears, huh? We have to be careful what we hear with them. The eyes, Allah musta'an. The internet now is full of it. The advertisement that they deliberately put, you go to a website to check your email, you find the ads on the left and the right of, meet, I don't know what type of woman, huh? Depending on the country, they put the country, matrimonial websites, meet each other, all this garbage that comes on the left and the right. Now, what are you supposed to do, check her out? No, you have to lower your gaze. You have to lower your gaze. Can't be going to these websites and say, well, maybe I'll find the righteous wife over there. Yes, sir. You're gonna find a righteous wife on a matrimonial website? Let your mother find you a righteous wife. You're not gonna find anything but garbage in these websites. All types of people, half of them are liars. And it's just, a'udhu billah, it's all kinds of corruption in these sites. So, this is the site. A lot of stuff is coming our way when it comes to vision. From the day of Eid, إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمَ اللَّهِ. Half of the women forget about, they remember Allah in Ramadan on the day of Eid, totally forgotten. They want to wear Eid clothes like men wear Eid clothes. It's not the same. Allah allowed men to adorn themselves and made it lawful for them, and there's no harm whatsoever in that. In fact, Allah loves it. And Allah commanded women to cover themselves. The thiyab al-Eid, the Eid clothes that the sister wants to wear, is at home. At home. Not outside when she's going to the musalla, or she's going to the musalla of Eid, and she's wearing high heels, 5-10 centimeters, and you tap tap tap, and she's walking by swinging left and right. Ishada, you're going to the musalla. What musalla are you going to? To who? What Lord are you worshipping? You're going there to do what? And what about the 1,000 men who are standing in the musalla, and all of these women are walking by? What about those people? Did you think that all of them will have to look at you because of the way you look and the way you sound? And then everyone who looks at you, you will gain their sin? Because you're the service provider. And if you're the man, you're responsible, my friend. You're responsible for making sure that your women folks are in line with the Sharia. Otherwise, stay at home. The best thing for the sister, if she can't obey Allah and her dress code, stay at home. Because for her also, the ayat will be applicable. They will bear witness against her. So, you know, all of these things which we take lightly, every time we say, ma'alayish, ma fi mushkila, the deen is easy. The deen is easy, not in this regard. This is not what ad-deen yusur means. Ad-deen yusur means if you're sick, huh? You can combine the prayers. If you're traveling, you can shorten the prayers and combine the prayers. If you're sick, you can break your fast. A lot of areas where you can, there's ease. You can wipe over the socks. You know what I'm saying? If you cannot stand up, you can pray sitting. And the list goes on of facilitation Allah brought. But those things we're discussing are not an area of facilitation. These are red lines that we cannot cross. So we have to remember these ayat and the impact they have in our lives now and the life to come. Proper understanding necessitates proper behavior. And then we will benefit from Ramadan. We can finish Ramadan and say, Alhamdulillah. Allah blessed me that I fasted the whole month and I prayed the whole month and I'm a better Muslim now. If we go back on our heels into a worse condition than before Ramadan, then what? Then we cannot, no one can say Ramadan was accepted. The ulama say there's no guarantee anyways. But there are signs that Ramadan was accepted or rejected. One of the signs is the condition of that person before and after Ramadan. If improved, alhamdulillah. If not, we have to worry. And so we cannot afford to do this to ourselves. Let us repent to Allah now from every haram thing we have seen with our eyes and every haram thing we have heard with our ears and every haram thing we engage with our limbs. Sincere tawbah. Now, when we meet that condition, if we fall back into it again, that's another discussion. It doesn't mean that we were not sincere now, but we will have to repent once again. But Allah knows who intends on going back and who's sincere. And you cannot say to yourself now, okay, I'll do 1 week tawbah. And I know after 2 weeks I'll do it again. It doesn't work. It doesn't work. You have to really have the resolve, I will never do this again. But we might, because of our weakness, because of our situation, we might fall back into it maybe a year later. The ulama say no problem. That does not nullify the current tawbah. However, when you fall into it again, then you do tawbah again. And you remain like this until you meet Allah. And this is, every son of Adam is sinful. We sin, we repent. We sin, we repent. We don't want to be sinful and careless about repentance. That is the path which we do not want to choose. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to protect us from that path. هذا والله أعلم وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.